Guangwu Mountain rises to an altitude of 2,507 meters and is the main peak of the Misung Mountains. It's said that one of the mountain passes here was in use as far back as the Ming and Qing dynasties. Was it an important pass to Sichuan on the Misung Road? Two groups of experts will join forces and enter the mountain area to look for remnants of the legendary Baiyu Pass. They try to locate the starting point of the Sichuan section of the Misung Road. The snow in Guansung Ping Pass hasn't melted yet. Fallen rocks lie strewn all over the road. The bad weather and harsh road conditions are creating huge difficulties for the investigation team. The cars are having difficulty moving forward. The team members try everything they can to increase the forward momentum of the vehicles. It's difficult for cars to move forward. So the team decides to continue their journey to the mountain on foot. According to historical records, in ancient times, the Misung Mountains were dangerous and steep. The roads here were very narrow. It was a desolate and uninhabited place where birds of prey often circled overhead. Eventually, as they continue on through the snow, the team finds the remains of the Baiyu Pass. It was built in the Qing Dynasty, and this discovery confirms it as the entrance point for the Misung Road into Sichuan. The team leaves Guangwu Mountain and heads for Nanjiang County in Sichuan Province. Located to the south of the Daba Mountain Range, Nanjiang is an important place in the border area, which bisects Sichuan and Shanxi. It's named after the Nanjiang River. This difficult journey has proved the veracity of ancient historical records, which mention how dangerous the Misung Road was in the past. This raises the question how the ancient Chinese built a road and passed through this place. There is a unique element in the story of Misung Road, water.
古人有个传统，古的流传，他喜欢圆活走，圆活修路，因为走大坝虚源、大坝到关坝比较陡，但是他总的翻山的这个路程短一些。The
team passes Liang He Ko, where plank road holes have been found, and soon comes to an old town. Here they will search for stories linking Misung Road with water. Was an ancient waterway once an important feature along the Misung Road? The remains of a plank road might be found along this river. Will they run in the same direction as the ones found in Liang He Ko? As expected, remains of some man-made structures are found at the Tuzaba. But are they the remains of the modern dam or an ancient plank road? These plank road holes do form a line with the ones found at Liang He Ko. The team will move forward and try to get an idea of the layout of the waterways and Misung Road and their connection to each other. The discovery of the plank road holes has made the routes of Misung Road much clearer. But what was its function in ancient times? Lu Li Temple in Nanjiang combines elements of Buddhism, Confucianism, and Taoism. Today, the experts have come here to study an inscription which mentions the Lu Li Pass. Why was this inscription put on a temple? Which part of the road was this temple built on? With these questions in mind, the team moves along the road. They notice that the terrain at this crossing looks strange. It seems that there used to be a pass here. On a barely noticeable stone tablet known as the Tan Mei Stone, the experts find a number of characters like this. On February 15th, 1133, the Jin army launched a full-scale attack against Sichuan. General Qing Ji rushed to Misung Road and hid in Langzong. This shows the military importance of Misung Road. 1258, a famous battle broke out in the east of Sichuan. Under the leadership of Mongke Khan, the formidable Mongolian cavalry came to Sichuan province and attacked the southern Song dynasty from three sides. Unexpectedly, the attacking army was defeated. Mongke Khan was shot dead, and the supposedly invincible Mongolian cavalry was stopped in its tracks. The army and people of the Southern Song Dynasty called it the Miracle of Fishing Town. After that, the Mongolian cavalry never regained the strength to move on and attack Europe. So, to some extent, this battle changed the outcome of world history. How did the Mongolian cavalry enter eastern Sichuan province? How did the Song army build their line of defense? What was the relation between this battle and Misung Road? Experts speculate that Misung Road runs along more than one route on its way into Sichuan. One route runs south to Nanjiang, and another runs to the east. Dahan Town, which was of strategic importance during the war against the Mongolian army, is on this route. Dahan Town is now known as Anji Town. The name Dahan proves that there was a link between Misung Road and the rise of the Han Empire. At that time, Liu Bang, the Han's founding emperor, made this place his stronghold and took power. So this place was named Dahan, meaning taking power and building the Han Empire. The Southern Song Army won the war against the Yuan Army using a strategy devised by local general Yu Jia in 1242. His plan was to build towns on mountains centered around Chongqing and make eight fortified settlements, which would comprise a strong line of defense. Dahan Town was one of the eight. Around the beginning of the 16th century, it was considered to be an important garrison town and renamed Anji Town. When the Red Fourth Army established its Sichuan Shanxi Revolutionary Base in 1932, it also served as a major logistics hub. Experts have studied inscriptions left by different dynasties here. These inscriptions reveal the military importance of Misung Road. The experts gradually work out one of the routes of Misung Road. It leads to another important place, Tongjian County. Tongjian is to the northeast of Bajong City and on the border area between Sichuan and Shanxi. It used to be the capital city of the Sichuan Shanxi Revolutionary Base of the Red Fourth Army. Remnants of 20th century warfare are everywhere. This route further displays the historical importance of Misung Road. What was it like? An official route, or a more informal track? A military route, or a trade conduit?
Misung Road 的性质学术界实际上是有不同看法的。比如说，有的学者就认为，它是官道；可是也有的学者提出一个鲜明的不同的看法，就认为是民间的通道。不过，我认为呢，它应该是官道。 举个例子来讲，在米仓道当中啊，我们也看到了，就是说栈道，就木头的栈道啊，是一种需要长时期不仅新建 工程量很大，而且呢，由于这个材质的这样一个原因，它需要有长时期的这样一个维护，制度化的一个维护维修。那么这样一个这个时候，如果不是有政府的这样一个力量，民间，特别是个人，他是没有力量来承担这样一个开凿和维修维护的这样一个功能的。
我也没看到，我看我们
挖的嘛，那个是
上宽啊，应该是吧？
上下宽嘛，你拍的是啊，下边嘛。
我拍的那边
。
In the old county of Baisha, outside Tongjian, the experts find an official inscription referring to the construction of a road. This proves that the government managed Misung Road. In 1072, Baisha County was incorporated into Tongjian County. These remains provide clues about the prosperity of this county in ancient times. The inscription and the links with the local county authorities indicate that this was a road highly valued by the government. An important feature of official roads is courier stations. So was there a courier station here somewhere?
Misung 道从来没是这个驿道，它是从因为这个军事意义更大，就是说军事上由于征战还是躲避这个官道上的这种征收赋税而形成的一条通道。
事实上一战有，我们在这个通江啊，在南江啊，都发现一些早期的驿站，早期的驿站恐怕现在不好找了。我们估计就是说在汉代、在唐代、宋代，它应该是有驿站的，应该是这些年代久远了，不清楚。但是在清朝，因为我自己觉得，在清朝的话，如果他在初年比较短的时间，他曾经作为一个官方，由阆中这边、巴中这边通往陕西那个重要通道的话，短暂的时期恐怕是有过驿站的。
The No Shui River in the north of Tongjian County originates in Nanjing County and connects with Liang Hako. It's flanked on both sides by steep mountains. In Tongjian, the mountains are steep and dangerous, and the rivers connect. This is a typical geomorphic feature of the Daba mountain area. Located in the west and east of the county, the No and Dung rivers cut through the area from north to south, dividing the mountains into three parts. How were roads built in such an inhospitable place to begin with? The experts walk along the valley, looking for remnants of Misung Road. Along this stone plank road, they find several man-made holes. These holes along the plank road by the No River share similarities with the ones found in Liang Hako. These discoveries show that waterways played an important role in the story of Misung Road. The flowing waters of the rivers meant the waterways became an indispensable part of the ancient road system. Misung Road had a unique and complete system of transportation routes. But who built such a large-scale and methodical road system?
个是。
哎，有了，有了。
一个人不行。
来两个，来两个。
断了，哦，这个两个人呢？哦哦哦，两个人才行。
来，站。哎，
真的。
一，等会儿，来。
是。
一，二，
三，有了，
有了，
有了，有了。你把石头怎么的？
都要放一下。
石头怎么的嘛？哦，对的，对对。
这谁的？
哎，天！哎，
出来跑！
妈妈，退下！哎呦，
跑跑跑，跑不了，跑不了！
我干掉他！
跑远了，爸爸！
爸爸，有纸，有纸，有纸，有纸！
全部是纸啊！
慢点，慢点，爸爸，再跑就跑了。
啊！慢点，慢点！三，
有了，记住哎！有了，慢点，只要你要，只要把你一人打，
全是纸。
红姐三，
红姐三呀！
三个。
七，
乾隆。
乾隆，46年。
啊，快快快！乾隆杯，哎呀，这儿哦，
这个很，哎，那个水把它洗，哦，
起来，你说去了，
让他来，
干嘛把
解用水，
把那个清洗一下，
啊，没事，接下去掉了，
还没拍完，
应该给你洗，
应该从这边，喂，从这边往这边擦，
环境下你看，于是重视。虽被通府大道，实为往来要经。上至秦省，下及巴达，就是说，虽然这个是一个重要的渡口，这个渡口连接的这个道路呢，上边到达陕西，下边到达了巴中和达州。
我们看到的许多修路的碑刻。大体都是，大致都是民间集资或者个别的富户领衔来主持这样的修筑工程的，并不是政府主持的官方的这种修筑工程，这可能是一个特点。
The discovery of official inscriptions in stone tablets make the true nature of Misung Road even more puzzling.Judging from the existing remains, the experts speculate that maybe the road was built by ordinary local people, but maintained and managed by the government. Did this road have other functions besides its general traffic and military functions? Will the experts find more proof from subsequent investigations?The secret of the construction of the road is hidden in cliff sculptures. The impregnable city, the secret waterway, and the stone tablet referring to Misung Road found in a dark corner mirror the past of this secret road. Join us for part 3 of Tracking the Ancient Misung Road.